Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'll show you how to fix the error message, which is UnityPlayer.dll is missing or not found on your Windows 10 or 11 computers. This error usually prevents your application from running and suggests that reinstalling the program might fix the issue. So without wasting any more time, let's jump right in. First, what you can do is try uninstalling the application that is showing the error. So what you do is go to Start menu and type Add or Remove Program. Then just locate the application in the list. Then click on the three dots and then click on Uninstall. After uninstalling, restart your computer to ensure any residual files are cleaned. Then visit the developer website and download and reinstall the Unity Player again or the particular affected application. This method often restores the missing Unity Player DLL files. Next, if reinstalling the application doesn't resolve the issue, you will need to repair the system files. So what you will do is go to Start menu and open Command Prompt as administrator. So type CMD on your Start menu, then choose Run as administrator, then click on Yes. After that, just simply type a few commands. So first, just simply type SFC scan now. So SFC space, then slash scan now. You can always find the command in the description box below. Now, once I've entered the first command, just simply hit Enter. Now, this process will take some time as it'll be restoring multiple files on your computer. So just be patient and wait for it to complete. And as you can see, the process has begun. So let me wait for it to complete. Now, once the status is in, do simply copy this second command, which is this one right over here. Then simply paste it, and this will also take some time. So just be patient and wait for it to complete. Now, after the commands are completed, simply enter exit and then simply restart your computer. So go to Start menu and restart your computer. So once the restart is completed, this will apply all the changes and hopefully resolve the Unity Player DLL issue. So that's it. By either reinstalling the application or running the commands, you should be able to fix the Unity Player DLL issue. I hope you found this video helpful. Please give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and subscribe to the channel for more helpful videos. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.